Ха!
Well, hello folks, and welcome back to the farm. As you can see, we've cultivated most of this field here, ready for the planting. So what we have to do now is just finish off the last of the cultivating here, which is just finishing these last bits up here, and then we should be ready to plant. So let's go ahead and start the cultivating, or finish off the cultivating. So again, we're just going to hire a worker. It's much easier to do that, and then we can take a walk around the farm and just see if there's anything else we can do that can earn us some money. So there we go, we'll start him off. Let's just have a quick look at the cultivator. There are various cultivators that you can buy in the game. Some are mostly wider than this, so you do a bigger strip, but obviously you need a more powerful tractor to pull that. There's some that cultivates and seeds, and there's also a cultivator that will cultivate and deposit manure as well, but obviously we need livestock for that to produce the manure. So that's basically what happens with this. He'll just go up and down until he's finished. So now if we just scroll through the rest of the farm or the machinery, now so you'll see we're still waiting for this grass here to grow so we can actually cut it for some more silage. And if we actually scroll through the fields, as you can see, nothing around the edge is actually growing, and we're into field 16. That's highlighted because it's actually green, but anywhere around the edges of the field we can actually cut any of the green areas for our silage. As you can see by them stats, there's nothing happening there, so we just go back to that tractor here. But it's not far off being ready to cut again, so obviously as soon as that starts showing signs, we can carry on cutting that. That's the machine we should be using. So what we can do is we can go and fill that up with the seeds. So let's check and see what we've got in stock at the minute. So as you can see, we got 40.5, anyway, that's tons of wheat, so we can do some more wheat. Or we can do some barley, or we can do some corn. So I think let's do some barley. I think we'll do some barley. So all you have to do is just check the little symbol that shows which is the barley, and that's what we have to load into the machine. So we're into the tractor here. So we drive over just in front of us and slightly to the right. So we'll check and see if we have a weight on that one. What we do is we drive over to here, and this is where our crops are stored. So what we want to do is choose what crop we're going to put in. So that one at the minute, if you look in the bottom right hand corner, that is showing, I believe that's wheat, so we don't want that. So if we press R1, if we press R2 and press the triangle, we can select. So that's wheat, that's the barley, that's callalone, I think that's just plain grass, I think that's corn, that's beetroot or beet. There is potato, but this machine won't plant potatoes, so that's the one we want. And now we just press R1. And that fills up the machine. So then all we need to do now is just drive this over. You must remember, whenever you've got a machine like this on the back of the tractor, it makes them very light on the front, so the steering's not as responsive. And obviously it's been quite heavy, this tractor struggles up the hill here. Just park on the verge here for a minute and then we're going to see where our cultivator is. Again, let's just watch the cultivator. See a car playing there. I believe that the hired worker will actually do that last narrow strip up the side. It's not really necessary, but you can go up and do that last bit. You could actually, at this point, if you wanted to, start the seeding process. But because that would mean hiring another worker, in effect, if you wanted to, you would then be spending more money. So we'll just let this one do his thing. What we're doing now, we just take this tractor down, park it next to the tractor that's waiting to start the sowing, and then we'll just swap tractors to do the next stage. We just park that there. We just take a walk around and have a look at the seed machine. As you can see, that's a So what we're going to do now is actually start the seeding process. So enter. So all we're going to do is just line yourself up so the hole's better just slightly over. I mean, you're not going to plant any seeds, so you want to be this sort of position. And we'll just do one without hiring a worker. So we press the L2. So we're going to turn on by pressing the square and we're going to lower it. And we're just going to go down the field in a straight line. Well, that's the plan. gone by my last experience, I couldn't keep it so straight. There we go, straight line. The worker doing it then, I do apologise, I'll do it myself. And I'll try and do it myself this time, so I'm actually driving it myself now. It's quite difficult to keep it in a... straight line. Bottom. Need to lift the sewing machine. As you can see, a slight different texture in the field now. That's a good indication that you sewed it. And you cannot actually sew over an area that's already done it. It just stopped. I'm going to line myself up, lower the machine, and follow a straight line again. It's quite difficult. Got quite a fair amount of concentration, got to keep it straight. That is the principle of sewing. All we do now is just go up and down. Seems to pull itself off, where it's the weight, seems to pull itself off. As we're actually going up quite a steep incline, it's getting slower, so you need the more powerful tractor. Hire the worker and you can watch the expert do it. And what will happen as this field becomes ready, it will start from this end, if you like, the first end that we've planted, that's where it will start ripening from at this end. So we're just lining it up there, press the circle, and he can go off and do his thing. Don't know whether it'll actually show up on the map. Yeah, if you can see at the top of field 16, the blue, the slightly blue strip, that's saying it's starting to grow, and it will go through various colours of blue, as you can see from the growing. So we can watch the progress on that. So what we're going to do now, I can't remember whether I demonstrated actually buying something, but what we're going to need to do for that plough, the tractor with the plough, and we're going to need to buy a weight for the front. So first thing we do is go into the shop, which is the triangle, and then we'll take our way to where I've probably gone flying straight, and there's the weights there. So we're going to buy a weight. So let's buy the heavier one there, we'll buy that one. So just to buy it, we press the X and we bought it. What we need to do is go and collect it. So we'll take the tractor that we're going to use it on. So we get into this one, detach the plow, and take yourself off over to the shop. Precious there, so we just drive up to it. That, folks, is basically all we need to do now is just wait for this guy here to finish his sewing, and obviously I'm not going to bore you with the whole process because that's all that happens. He goes up and down sewing season. All we have to do is wait until they're ready to harvest. In the meantime, we can of course cut grass for silage and build that stock up. But for now, this is all that's going to happen. So I will allow this man to do his thing, and when we get near the end, I will do another video of sort of end process, its last bit. So I hope that this has been interesting again, and you've seen how we process the whole stage of planting. The first stage was to actually harvest the field, and then we prepared the field for the next harvest, and now we're planting. So once this is grown, we can harvest it again. That's the full cycle, and all crops are basically the same, and field preparation is basically the same. Whatever crop we grow, it's all going to be the same process. So once we've done this, then the next process, we can then start selling some of our crops. But for now, I'm going to leave it with this man going up and down the field, or it might be a lady farmer, we don't know. So I hope you've enjoyed this perhaps shorter video on getting started in Farm Simulator, and we'll catch you again soon. Bye bye for now.